Hello friends, today let me delve into one of the most asked questions we get as inquiries. I'm from a tier 2, tier 3 college. Can I make it into investment banking? Spoiler alert, the answer is yes. A resounding yes, and I'm going to tell you exactly how in this video. Listen, I know what you must be thinking. Investment banking is all about those Ivy Leagues, top tier schools, big shot networks. Well, that's partially true. But here's the thing. It's not the full picture. Just because you didn't get into a top 10 college doesn't mean that you're out of the game. It just means you need to have a smarter game plan. So how do we work it out? You understand what has happened that cannot be reversed. So let's try to be a part of a solution than being a victim of the problem. So how you're going to approach this is the deal. First thing, upgrade your skills. Investment banks want one thing, value. If you can show them that you have the skills, the knowledge, and the drive, you've already set yourself apart. First thing first, master the technical skills, financial modeling, valuations, Excel expertise, Power BI, and understanding of financial statements, understanding the finer nuances of valuations of companies inside out. The Wall Street School, for example, trains tons of students from tier 2 and tier 3 colleges who have cracked top Ivy jobs because they knew their stuff better than anyone else. Point number two, networking. Here's where you level the playing field. You might not have a prestigious campus alumni network, but leverage LinkedIn. That is your alumni network. Don't just send cold connection requests to anyone and everyone. Engage meaningfully, comment on industry posts, share insights, and connect with professionals who resonate with your journey. I'm also very active on LinkedIn, you know, and I built that over a period of time by being active in terms of my personal engagement. Remember, don't just ask for a job. Instead, ask for guidance, opinions, and insights. So bottom line, you have to build relationships and not just connections. That's what I have been able to do in my personal journey also as mentor and as a co-founder of the Wall Street School. And I've been able to connect with a lot of students, and professionally it has given me a lot of results as well. Okay. Now, point number three, target boutique firms for experience, because you might not get into the top league investment banks in the initial phase. And this is where you can actually get an edge. Target boutique firms, smaller financial consulting agencies, or even startups that need financial expertise. I mean, the big banks often look for prior experience, and they don't care whether it's a Goldman Sachs or a small investment bank. They want to see that you've worked on real deals, you've done real financial analysis and valuation models. Get your hands dirty and then leverage that experience when applying for bigger role in bigger companies. Next thing is, when you actually get that break, how you actually close that is how you build your story, because the story you tell matters. Because investment banking is as much about storytelling as it's about the numbers. When you walk into that interview, they need to feel your journey. Talk about the challenges you faced coming from a tier 2 or tier 3 college and how you have overcome them. Show them your hustle, your resilience, and hunger that makes for a unique candidate. In the Wall Street School, we have had a candidate who is a KBC 7 crore winner, Sarthak Narula. 7 crore! Who did the workshop after being the winner in KBC. Right? We have had Raktab Datta, you know, Assam's number 2 tennis player who quit tennis at the age of 21 because of sports injury, took the workshop and subsequently got placed in an investment bank. We have had so many candidates from tier 2 and tier 3 colleges, MBA colleges, who got placed and were at the mercy of sales job from their colleges, selling either CASA products or mutual funds or insurance in the name of MBA finance. They did the workshop and subsequently got placed in proper investment banking domain. We've had an MBA gold medalist candidate from Pulwama, you know, who despite being a gold medalist did not get any job because no companies were hiring during COVID. She's right now in London having a life she deserves post her placement. why should we hire you over an Ivy League candidate? That's the unspoken question. Your answer should be because I'm hungrier, more driven, and have something to prove. Next, friends, you got to realize and understand the importance of mentors. At your end, don't underestimate the power of having a mentor or a guide. Reach out to professionals who have walked the path you want to take. You know, they could be your biggest allies. Whether it's helping you refine your resume, preparing for your interview, or simply giving you a morale boost, mentors are invaluable. And trust me, there are people who are willing to help you if you just ask them the right direction. And this is where our role as Watch It School comes in too. As a co-founder of my company, I've taught more than 25,000 students. Same goes with my partner, Manoj Goyal also. Now, we don't get job satisfaction by just teaching you. We get our job satisfaction when we as a firm become that zariya or the catalyst through which we are able to transform lives and transform careers. And this is what our role is in the Wall Street School. We don't want to be just a coaching center, and we are not. We want to give you an experiential learning where we mentor you. This is your capabilities as to what is the best recourse for you. That's what we have been doing for so many years. And if you still have doubts, let me tell you about the real success stories we have seen at the Wall Street School. We've had students from the colleges you probably have never heard of who are sitting across boardroom tables in top investment banks. Because it's not about where you start, it's about where you finish. And with the right strategy, you can finish strong. And if you can see the placement page on our website alongside, there are so many success stories of people, you know, who were at the initial phase or the nascent phase in their career, you know, and they are right now at very senior level positions in different companies. I mean, we started way back in 2009, and those students who were at junior level positions at that time, they are right now at very, very senior level positions in different companies across the world. And that has been our biggest earning so far as the co-founders of the Wall Street School, because we as a firm have grown along with their growth. And the biggest thing that we've earned has been the goodwill of those students, you know, who are right now at very senior level positions in different companies. So if you're ready to hustle, ready to put in the work, and ready to take control of your future, don't let your college tag hold you back. Drop your questions in the comment below. And remember, you can be the underdog who turns the tables. And if you want personalized guidance, check out the links in the description of our programs at the Wall Street School. Until next time, keep grinding and let's hope for a better future for everyone. You know, not having MBA from a tier one college is not the end of the world. There are a lot of success stories we have had, and yours is also possible.